one of the bloodiest killers of Russia's second capital, St. Petersburg. By the age of 25, he committed 10 murders. Why was he called the resort maniac? I'll tell you all about it in today's video. Eduard Vasilievich Shimyakov, a Russian serial killer, operated in St. Petersburg from 1996 till 1998. He committed 10 murders and 2 attempt murders. Before taking the victim's life away, he forced his victims into sexual intercourses. He always killed with extreme brutality. In at least one case, he engaged in cannibalism and ate his prey. Bloody Edik was born in 1975 in the Zhytomyr region of Ukraine. Afterwards, he and his parents moved to St. Petersburg, where he committed all of his crimes. He served in the border troops near the city of Alexandrovska. There, he was bullied from the grandfather's side, and this had a large impact on his future. Shimyakov was starved and locked up in a refrigerator overnight. The guy gained hatred from the whole world and started to close up from the rest. After returning home from the army in 1996, Eduard started to live with his parents. He didn't communicate with his siblings at all. He didn't have girlfriends and permanent relationships. Somehow it didn't work out. At all. He got a job as a security guard and periodically suffered from severe headaches. It would seem an ordinary guy, nothing special, but everyone has their own secrets. How did the idea of killing women came into the head of the young man? Most likely this is because females didn't pay any attention to Edik. He was unattractive and short, and he certainly didn't like this. Having suffered without a relationship for several years, Shimyakov got mad and decided to take revenge. However, the maniac himself claimed that he was badly influenced by the movie about the war, The Dawns Here Are Quiet. The one that told about the tragic death of a female platoon and anti-aircraft gunners. What did the future maniac see in the heroic film? The interesting thing is that in the movie, women died. Each girl had their own special death that was shown in detail and for a long time on the screen. One died from a shot of a bullet, another drowned in a swamp. Young Edik eagerly looked at the scenes of death of young and beautiful women and realized that he wanted to see these scenes in front of him in reality. He wanted to decide the future of others himself. Shimyakov committed his crimes from 1996 to 1998. The scenario was about the same with every victim. He tied the victim's hands, inflicted numerous stab wounds, satisfied his sexual needs with the barely breathing victim, and then took the life away with the same knife. His first victim was a 19-year-old girl, whom the maniac ambushed in a non-crowded place and stabbed her multiple times with a knife. Then he abused and covered the body with branches, just like in the movie The Dawns Here Are Quiet, and left the body to die. The body of another victim was found only a month later. It was also covered with branches. 5 out of the 10 victims of the maniac were underage. One girl was barely 10. She just walked away from the company where her parents were, to the nearest forest, and met the maniac there. Most of the crimes Shimyakov committed in Karelsky, outside St. Petersburg. It was a place to rest. There was a beach, that's why he was nicknamed as the resort maniac. Eduard always attacked unexpectedly, suddenly. For him, the most important thing was the momentary satisfaction of his own sexual desire, while the age and the appearance of the victim didn't matter. The most important was the general attractiveness and conformity of the image that he had developed in his head. At one moment, Shimyakov decided to add mockery to the rest of the crimes and abuse the bodies of the poor girls. In addition to separating parts, he could lay out limbs in a certain composition. Sometimes Eduard also took trophies. It could be a book, or travel card, or even a passport of his victims. Sometimes the maniac unexpectedly went over the top and inflicted countless wounds on the already lifeless body. This happened with the body of a 19-year-old college student, Marina. The detectives counted around 53 wounds on her innocent body. And yet, two victims managed to escape the terrible fate. The criminal's first misfire occurred in the August of 1996. He was frightened off by a man passing by. The second time, the maniac left his victim alive in November of the same year. A girl named Oksana, whom Alexei already managed to inflict severe stab wounds, suddenly began to beg him to leave her. Apparently, something clicked in the criminal's head. Perhaps this behavior didn't fit into the image of the classic victim that he had developed in his head. He stopped, helped the girl to get up, and walked her home. While saying goodbye, he even asked Oksana to contact the police and report his appearance, realizing that Eduard was extremely dangerous for society. He probably wanted to be stopped because he couldn't stop on his own. Unfortunately, Oksana was too frightened after what happened to her and did not dare to turn to the authorities, fearing the revenge of the maniac, since after all, he knew where she lived. It is interesting that after this incident, Shemyakov didn't dare to pick up a knife for over 6 months. During the interrogations, he refused to confess what he was doing all this time. Although, according to some reports, they said that the maniac met a girl with whom they had a short relationship and who later left him. This angered the criminal even more, but he didn't touch the girl. Apparently, he loved her too much and didn't wish her death. The last victim of the terrible serial killer became his sister's girlfriend. It all happened on a warm summer day, July 2, 1998. The parents went to the countryside, and Edik decided to invite over a girl he knew, a 17-year-old Zhenya. After a short conversation, the maniac attacked the girl and stabbed her several times with a blunt object, after which he separated parts of her body in the bathroom and decided to taste her. He cut off a piece, fried it, and ate it along with the cranberries that he kept in the refrigerator. He buried the remaining parts in the nearest wasteland, but kept a few parts for himself. This is exactly what led to his exposure. The mother returned from the country house only a month later after the crime was committed, in the beginning of August. She immediately found out about the disappearance of her daughter's friend, and when she went home and opened the refrigerator, she was stunned. It contained leftover body parts, and bloody pieces of clothing were scattered around the apartment. As a reasonable person, the woman realized that there simply is no point in covering up her son. She immediately called the police, which set an ambush in the apartment. This was reported to Edward by a neighbor, but he just simply replied that he doesn't care anymore and went straight to the authorities. Maybe after all, he really was tired of killing and he wanted to get rid of his terrible passion. The psychiatrists immediately began to work with Shemyakov. They were the ones to come up to the conclusion that the suspect is insane. Eduard was diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia. He was completely unable to comprehend the full horror and consequences of his actions. Nonetheless, the maniac testified about the crimes that he committed. The detectives went to investigative experiments with him. Thanks to this, the exact number of victims and their names were unknown. Shemyakov himself claimed that some eyes in the water forced him to kill. He saw them in every reservoir, stream of water in the apartment, and in the bathroom. They called for murder. They promised that after a series of murders, he would become the wisest person on earth and become superhuman. After a long period of interrogations, the court declared that the maniac is insane. In 2002, Eduard Shemyakov was sent for compulsory treatment. Until this day, he still currently is in a specialized psychiatrical hospital. The relatives of the victims repeatedly tried to challenge the verdict, but to no avail. Nevertheless, this situation is really different from the rest. Usually the maniacs are proved sane, despite the obvious horror of their crimes. The relatives of the victims are convinced that Shemyakov is faking his insanity, but the doctors think differently. They recognized Eduard as a deeply ill person. So far, he has no chance for a cure. He is constantly under the supervision of doctors. But if suddenly Eduard is cured, he would be counted as sane, and according to the law, the maniac just has to be released. Why couldn't the police find Shemyakov for such a long time? After all, after the first murders in 1996, the police started to look for the maniac. Everything was simply explained. Of course, the people with diagnosis were the first to be suspected, but no one could have thought that this quiet guy was a schizophrenic. Edward even had a permit to own weapons, and these permits are not issued to insane people. Therefore, the law enforcement agencies weren't interested in him. According to the old criminal code, Eduard Shemyakov would be sentenced to execution. According to the new one, life imprisonment. In both cases, the society would get rid of him forever. Shemyakov cannot live among people. This is especially well understood by the relatives and friends of the girls whose graves are still lined with fresh flowers, although many years have passed since their funerals. They were buried in white dresses because they were all pure, trusting, defenseless, and innocent. Edik loved every single one of them, but only in one moment, at the moment of their death. The place where Eduard Shemyakov is currently being treated is located in the city of St. Petersburg. Two-thirds of the patients there are killers. Every 6 months, the patients undergo a commission that notes the dynamic of their condition. If the results of the examination are positive, in other words, the mental illness has begun to decline, then the recovering patient has a real chance to be free soon. On average, a patient spends 3-4 years in the mental hospital. I think it's not just me that finds the thought that such people can go free again terrifying.